Good afternoon, students. Today I am going to discuss about a Grand Test 11 paper discussion of full syllabus. Okay. First question is the reaction which is induced in the preparation of ethane from chloroethane is. See, chloroethane to ethane they are doing. Chloroethane, this is chloroethane. Chloroethane, they are get converted into ethene by using alcoholic potassium hydroxide, formation of ethene. This is, you know, that it is nothing but dehydrohalogenation reaction. It is a dehydrohalogenation. Halogen is removed as well as hydrogen is removed. So halogen is removed from this carbon and hydrogen is removed from this carbon. So this is alpha carbon, this is beta carbon. So this is called beta elimination, the reaction which is induced in the preparation of ethane from the chloroethane is beta elimination. Okay, next one, this is simple reaction, this you have studied in alkyl halide chapter. Next question, number 47, what will be the product formed when B obtained in the following reaction undergoes oxidation? See, B is forming and it is further undergoing oxidation. This, if it is not visible clearly, I will write it. Benzene, they are treating with the methyl chloride, nothing but Friedel-Crafts reaction in presence of anhydrous aluminum chloride. There is a formation of toluene. Toluene on oxidation gives benzoic acid. What is that? Benzene is treated with the methyl chloride. Okay, B is forming. This is B. This B undergoes oxidation gives benzoic acid. Okay. That is 47, Friedel-Crafts reaction followed by oxidation. Next one, which of the following product is formed when cyclohexanone, I made correction there, just to make a correction, cyclohexanone, here last letter is mixed, cyclohexanone react with the OH minus ion followed by heating. So what happens there, I will write reaction for that. This is cyclohexanone. It is reacting with the OH minus ion and there is a negative charge is generated there. Hydrogen is combined with water there and this will react further with one more mole of cyclohexanone and there is a formation of this intermediate. This intermediate cyclohexanone is linking here and O will be there, this O minus and H plus will be there. Again, this is acidified. Acidified will get the oxygen here. Again, you link this one. OH is here. Hydrogen will be there as usual. Again, they are heating it. After heating, what happens? Here, OH of this, hydrogen of this will come out and there is a formation of double bond. OH of this, hydrogen of this, water, and between these two rings, there is a formation of bond. Okay, this is cyclohexanone. Okay, OH minus ion, hydrogen combines H2O, negative charge is generated. Okay, and this is combining to one more cyclohexanone, forming this intermediate. Further, it is reacting as acidified and heated. There is a formation of double bond. So, for question number 48, this is the option. So, this product is this one only. Next question, this is after 46, 47, and 48. Next question, 49. Which of the following equation does not correctly represent the first law of thermodynamics? See, students, there is a chance of mixing of questions. Don't think that they'll ask first second year question, then first year question, or first year question, then second year question. No, like that, it will not be there. They may mix all the questions. Right, this is question number 49. It is related to first law of thermodynamics. Okay. Ink does not correctly represent, they're asking, does not correctly representing, they're asking. So I am going for fourth option because all these are correct. See, for isothermal process, what happens? Delta E is equal to zero, then Q is equal to minus W, it becomes. For cyclic process, delta E is equal to zero, then Q is equal to minus W. For isochoric process, isochoric process, delta V is zero. So then what happens? Obviously, the delta E becomes Q. For adiabatic process, Q is equal to zero. Hence, delta E is equal to W. Positive W will be there. But they have given negative W. That is not correct. Question number 49. For isothermal process, change in internal energy is zero. This for cyclic, zero. Isochoric, a change in volume, delta V is equal to zero. Therefore, fourth option for adiabatic process, Q is equal to zero. Then what happens? Delta E is equal to W, but they have given minus W. Not correct. Then which of the following statement is not characteristics of free radical chain reaction? Which of the following statement is not a characteristics of free radical chain reaction? This you have come across in first year chapter, that is hydrocarbon chapter. There for chemical properties of haloalkanes, chemical properties of alkanes. This there you have studied the mechanism. Okay, that directly will tell you what is given there. Chlorination of methane they have given. Chlorination of methane is given. There what you have studied, actually what you have studied there, free radical chain reaction. First what happens is initiated by UV light. It proceeds in three main steps like initiation, chain, next propagation, then termination will be there. Three steps will be there actually. Initiation step, propagation step, termination steps. Okay, but what they have given, it is usually sensitive to change in solvent. No, no lena dena with the solvent. Okay, the free radical reaction is initiated by UV light. It proceeds in three main steps. Initiation, propagation, termination. It gives the major product derived from the most stable free radical. Okay, question number 50th is second option. 51, which of the following cannot be oxidized by hydrogen peroxide? See, this can be oxidized, this can be oxidized, this can be oxidized. Ozone is there. When you are expecting, see, you know that hydrogen peroxide can behave as oxidizing as well as reducing. Here, hydrogen peroxide cannot undergo, it cannot oxidize ozone. Instead of that, it reduces, hydrogen peroxide reduces O3 to O2. Okay, the reaction is like this. Hydrogen peroxide reacting with the O3, formation of S2O, formation of S2O plus 2O2. In this reaction, hydrogen peroxide but reacting with an ozone, formation of S2 and O2. So ozone is not oxidizing. Sorry, hydrogen peroxide, not the ozone is not oxidized by hydrogen peroxide, but it reduces to O2. Chemical properties of hydrogen peroxide. This you have come across in the chapter, hydrogen chapter. Question number 52, they are talking about some, which of the following statement is correct about the given reaction? Which of the following statement is or correct about the given reaction? What is that? The first one, what they have given, less substituted alkene is a predominant alkene. That is right. OH minus ion functions as a base in E2 elimination. That is also right. The above reaction is known as a Hoffmann elimination. Yes, this is called Hoffmann elimination. When 1, 2, 3 are correct, then 4. All the above statements are correct only. All the above statements are correct. Okay, because here quaternary ammonium hydroxide on heating, quaternary ammonium hydroxide on heating strongly decomposes to yield tertiary amine and water and alkene. Okay, all statements are correct because what is happening, what is the reaction here? Quaternary ammonium hydroxide on heating strongly decomposes to yield water, tertiary amine and alkene. Okay, reaction is this one only. I don't want to write reaction, same reaction it is. 53, the method which is used to convert hydrated alumina into anhydrous alumina. Hydrated alumina into anhydrous alumina. Question is related to metallurgy chapter. Okay, there you have studied about the words. Calcination process. Calcination means what? Is a process in which ore is heated in the limited supply of air. Or in the absence of air. Okay, they are heating in the presence of limited supply of air or absence of air below the melting point of the metal. The method used to convert hydrated alumina into hydroxide, that itself calcination. Here, what they do, hydrated alumina can be written like this, aluminium hydroxide, hydrated alumina. It is heated actually around 1500 degrees centigrade and there is a formation of aluminium oxide plus water molecules. Alumina, hydrated alumina means aluminium hydroxide only, heated to 1500 degrees centigrade, there is a formation of aluminium oxide. Okay, this is called calcination. Hydrated ore become anhydrous. Okay, here dressing, smelting, roasting also chance possibilities are there, but here, especially for the extraction of aluminium, they are going for calcination. Okay, roasting they are doing in the presence of air. Chances is there, again, some moisture may attack. If you are going for roasting, chances is there some moisture may attack to this alumina oxide. To avoid absorption of H2O molecules on Al2O3, they are using calcination process. Dressing, smelting and all, moisture chances are there. In option number 2, option number 3, option number 4, in these three options, moisture absorption chances are there. But we want anhydrous alumina, that is why I am going for calcination. Strictly I am going for calcination. 54, xenon hexafluoride on complete hydrolysis yield X. Okay, that reaction I will write directly. Question number 54, I will write xenon hexafluoride reacting with 3H2O molecule, formation of xenon trioxide, 6 moles of hydrogen fluoride. Okay, xenon trioxide is forming and it is having pyramidal structure. See, option number 1, no chance. Option number 4, no chance. Possibility is there of third and second option. But here it is given trigonal planar wrong, pyramidal is correct. Okay, two options are eliminated. Option number 1 and 4 are eliminated. Then remaining are 2 and 3. 2 and 3 are remaining. So in 3, trigonal planar structure is there, not possible. Then you have to go for third option. 54 is third option. 55, solubility of calcium chloride in terms of, it is AB, very important. Based on this, definitely one question they will ask in the competitive exams. Need, definitely they will ask one question related to solubility product. Remember students, easy it is. For calcium chloride itself, I will derive. There is a formation of calcium 2 plus plus 2 Cl minus ion. Calcium plus plus 2 Cl minus ion. Assume that solubility of calcium 2 plus is S. Solubility of chlorine is 2S. Because 2 are there, no? Therefore, it is 2 are there, no? Therefore, it is 2. So, then what is next step, you know? Solubility product KSP is equal to S into 2S square. Whatever the coefficient is there, that becomes a power. So, that becomes 4S cube. So, KSP is equal to 4S cube. But they are asking for S. Solubility they are asking. Solubility is equal to cube root of solubility product divided by 4, or we can say KSP by 4 to the power of 1 by 3. Very important. It is of Ab2 type of electrolyte. All Ab2 type of expressions, they will have Ab2 type of salt will have solubility product is equal to 4S cube. KSP is equal to 4S cube. Remember, friends, in some book they are given only solubility product. SP is equal to 4S cube. Both are same only. Solubility product is represented by KSP or SP. Question number 55. Then, which option goes now here? 55 is third option. Next, which one of the following halogen is oxidized by nitric acid? Which one of the following halogen is oxidized by nitric acid? That is iodine generally. Many times you have come across this reaction. Okay, iodine is reacting with the standard balancing equation. It is I2 plus 10 HNO3 gives iodic acid plus 10 NO2. Plus 4H2O, easy. This is a standard reaction. Iodine is reacting with the nitric acid, formation of HiO3. Nitric acid can oxidize. Fluorine not possible, chlorine not possible, bromine not possible, iodine is possible. Okay, a nitric acid can take electron from iodine easily because of its low ionization energy. Why it is not possible? They have high ionization energy. They will not give electrons so easily. As you know, that ionization energy decreases down the group. So nitric acid can take electron from iodine easily. Hence, option number 4 is correct. Why 1, 2, 3 are not possible? Because they are having high ionization energy. Okay, remember, to take electron also, it should have some capacity. Otherwise, it is not possible. Then question number 57, among the following pair, which pair has same size? This is related to lanthanide contraction. So this has come across even in theory also. Zirconium and hafnium, they are having same size because of lanthanide contraction. Zirconium and hafnium. Question number 58. Bulbs A and B are connected by a tube having stopcock. Bulb A has 100 ml volume containing hydrogen gas. After opening the gas from A to the evacuated bulb B, the pressure falls by 40%. Then volume must be. Okay, that is, we can use formula. Using with the help of Boyle's law at constant N and T, we have an expression. We have used this expression. Okay, P initial, P1, V1 is equal to P2, V2. You can say this is a initial pressure, initial volume, final pressure, final volume. If you take that, so P1 V1, this can be P1 V1 is equal to 0.6 of, because 40% it is reduced, P1 V1 plus V2. So this is P1 V1 is 100 and 0.6, this is P1 100 plus V2 If you solve this V2, you will get 66 mathematics part using P1-V1 relation. P1-V1 relation, that is according to Boyle's law. Boyle's law I am using here. There are Boyle's law at constant temperature and constant N also we can say. Okay. Then question number 59. The value of equilibrium constant for the following reaction is 0.5 at 400. What is the value of Kp? This is again a simple common question. With the help of relation, Kp is equal to Kc R to the power of delta N. Kp is equal to Kc RT to the power of delta N. Kp is equal to Kc R to the power of delta N. So here what they are asking, value of equilibrium constant for the following reaction is given. What is the value of Kp at 400 degrees centigrade? They are asking, what is the value of Kp? So here Kc is given 0.5. Kc is given 0.5. R value, T value, R value, you can substitute delta N. I'll see that delta N here 2 minus 4 product side. Delta N stand for number of gaseous moles of product minus number of gaseous moles of reactant. That is two ammonia are there. Number of gaseous moles of product are 2. Number of gaseous moles of reactant are 4. Therefore, it is minus 2. Delta N is equal to minus 2. RT to the power of delta power of minus 2, 0.5. 0.5 R value 0.082. Temperature 673 Kelvin to the power of minus 2. If you solve this, we'll get 164 10 to the power of minus 4. That is, we can change 1.64 into 10 to the power of minus 4. 1.64 10 to the power of minus 4. Multiply with the round off value, you will get third option. 1.64 10 to the power of minus 4. 59. Sorry, see, it is a third option. It is misprinting. Third option. Minus 4 it is. Next question number 60. 60 it is direct reaction. Okay, benzene is reacting with the chlorine. Chlorine gas in presence of UV light and the temperature is maintained 500 Kelvin, there is a formation of gamma hexane. Chlorine. So second option is correct. Evergreen reaction, it is old reaction. Okay, in the presence of sunlight they are doing this reaction. So gamma hexane is going to be formed. Question number 60th is second option. 61, which one of the following statement is not true about the effect of an increase in temperature on the distribution of molecular speed of a gas? States of matter chapter. Which one of the following statement is not true about the effect of an increase in temperature on the distribution of molecular speed in a gas? See, what is a graph? What we have observed, graph generally, if you plot a graph, that is fraction of molecules. If you plot a graph of fraction of molecule versus molecular speed is x-axis and x-axis is a fraction of molecules. If you plot a graph like this, then what we'll get, this is a graph obtained at T1 temperature and this is a graph obtained at T2 temperature. This is T1 temperature and it is T2 temperature. Here T2 is more than T1. The peak of the distribution of curve corresponds to the most probable speed. We can notice with increase in temperature, fraction of the molecule with the most probable speed decreases. Okay, decreases. So that is why what they have given, the area under the distribution curve remains the same. What they are asking, not true, they are telling. See that, not true, which is not true, they are asking. First option itself not true. The area under the distribution curve, the area under the distribution curve remains the same? No. No, because what we are observing from this peaks, the peaks of the distribution of curve corresponds to the most probable speed. We can notice from this what we can understand, what we can see, we can notice that with increase in temperature, fraction of molecule with the most probable speed decreases. As it is in the graph, you see that bar, that is in graph, we can make out this. Okay, so that is why first option is incorrect. Then we go for question number 62. Which of the following process represent change in the optical rotation of freshly prepared solution of glucose? Okay, that is question number 62 about this. You know that direct definition, even physics also it is there, it is Mutar rotation. Question number 62 is a Mutar rotation. It is a spontaneous change in the specific rotation of a solution of optically active compound is called Mutar rotation. Definition, that is a spontaneous change in the specific rotation of a solution of an optically active compound is called Mutar rotation. The specific rotation gradually decreases. For glucose decreases from 111 degree to 52.5 degree decreases in case of alpha glucose. In case of alpha glucose, this happens. Specific rotation decreases from 111 degree in case of alpha glucose. The specific rotation gradually decreases from 111 to 52.5 degree in case of ender. in case of beta glucose increases. In case of beta glucose increases from 19.2 degree to 52.5 degrees. Specific rotation is increasing for beta glucose. For alpha glucose there is a decrease. For beta glucose there is an increase takes place. Values 19.2 degree to 52.5 degree. Here decrease for alpha glucose, the specific rotation gradually decreases from 111 degree to 52.5 degree. So this is nothing but Mutar rotation. Mutar rotation, a spontaneous change in the specific rotation of a solution of an optically active compound is called Mutar rotation. Next, 63, there is any reaction they have given. Reaction is given there. A equilibrium constant for the given reaction is given. The total pressure of gas in equilibrium at 30 degree centigrade. So total for this equation, if I'm writing an expression, how I'm going to write? See, this is a there and this is there. This I'll take it as x. This is x. We can write Kp is equal to ammonia, pressure of ammonia, what we have, into pressure of carbon dioxide. So here Kp is given already. Kp value is given in the question itself. Kp is given 2.9 10 to the power of minus 5. That is equal to, this I am taking as x, pressure of ammonia. This is x, 2x square x. If you solve for x, then what happened? 2.9 10 to the power of minus 5. This is 5x, this is 4x square, and this is x is there. So it becomes 4x cube. If you solve for x, we will get 0.0914 atmosphere. Then total pressure goes to C, then here F X you are getting, then total pressure. Total pressure, that is 2x plus x. So x I have solved 0.0914, or we can take this as a 3x, simple way, 3 into 0.0914 if I am doing means we get 0.0582. See students, what I did, this is equilibrium type of problem. Here this you take it as ammonia gas initially, because it is anyway it is solid, no need to take up solid. For a solid, no need to worry. This is a solid, it is not producing any pressure, so I am not counting anything. Ammonia is a gas, carbon dioxide is a gas. So initial pressure, let us take it as ammonia as x, and this is x, this is 2x and this is x. Okay, we have an expression, this is equilibrium constant, that is a pressure of product divided by the pressure of the reactant. Reactant anyway it is solid, I am not counting it. So this is taken as Kp value is given. Let pressure I have taken as x, that is 2x into x. If you solve for x, 0.0194. But total pressure they are asking in the question, they are asking the total pressure of the gaseous mixture, that is 2x plus x, that is 3x. X value is substituted from this, you will get answer 0.0582. 63 is 0.0582. Fourth option is a right option. Fourth option is a right option here. 63, fourth option. Next we'll go for 64. 64. What are the spin only magnetic momentum for nickel 2 ions in the square planar and octahedral? Spin only magnetic momentum in the square planar and in octahedral geometry. Means magnetic momentum they are asking in square planar and in octahedral geometry. Square planar, number of unpaired electrons usually nickel 2 plus. In square planar, number of unpaired electrons are 0. You can see that example what is there in NCERT. Here n value, that is number of unpaired electrons, number of n stand for number of unpaired electrons, nickel plus 2 in square planar structure, square planar n is equal to 0, whereas in case of octahedral n is equal to 2. So according to this, in square planar anyway it is 0. So options, you see that question number 64, option number 1, option number 3, option number 4, all 3 are 0 only. When n value is equal to 2, then what is the logic I used to tell in class? If number of unpaired electrons are 2, its magnetic momentum will be 2.83, 2 point something will be there. No need to calculate using formula mu is equal to square root of n into n plus 2, not necessary. Logic is there in chemistry. If number of unpaired electrons are 2, then what happens? Then magnetic momentum, number of unpaired electrons are 2, magnetic momentum will be 2 point something. I used to say in class, if n value is equal to 3, magnetic momentum will be 3 point something something. 3 point some value will be there. If unpaired electrons are 4, 4 point some value will be there. This is a logic for finding magnetic momentum. So you can save your time without doing calculation. Number of unpaired electrons are 4 means 4 point something will get. Right. Okay, so ulta also you can think. If 4 magnetic momentum is mu is equal to 4 point something is there, then unpaired electrons are 4. Reverse also you can see, if the magnetic momentum is given 3 point something, number of unpaired electrons are 3, right? So question number 64 related, question is related to magnetic momentum. Question is related to magnetic momentum. You can see this in square planar, no unpaired electrons in square planar geometry. Number of unpaired electrons in equal 2 plus is 0. Okay, if you want to have square planar structure, it has to undergo sp3 or dsp2 hybridization. dsp2 hybridization. Whatever the electrons are there, they get paired. So magnetic momentum become no unpaired electrons. Hence magnetic momentum become 0 there. 64. Next question. Next one is 65. The special arrangement of two or more polypeptide chain with respect to each other is known as, that is quaternary structure. 65 directly, two or more peptide chains may associate to give rise to the quaternary structure. These are held together by non-covalent force such as hydrogen bonds, electrostatic interaction and van der Waals interactions will be there. So which is responsible? You see, you have studied there in biology also, there hydrogen bonds will be there. If no hydrogen bond, then van der Waals force of attraction will be there. Hydrogen bond will be there, or van der Waals force of attraction will be there. Van der Waals force. Question number, this is biology related question much. Product obtained on the reaction of 3-chlorocyclopentene with the silver nitrate is, question number 66. Easy reaction. Of course, you have not come across this reaction in your syllabus, but this is for testing your basics. This question is for testing your basics. Here we have NO2, product obtained on the reaction of 3-chlorocyclopentene with the silver nitrate. 3-chlorocyclopentene. See, here it is Cl. Chlorine will be there. Chlorine will be there. When it is made to react with the silver nitrate, AgNO3, then this chlorine is replaced. Simple. Simple way. Double bond will be there. And NO2. Okay. So, this is 3-chlorocyclopentene. 3-chlorocyclopentene. 1, 2, 3. Chlorine will be there. 3-chlorocyclopentene on reaction with the AgNO2. Cl of this, silver of this come out as a byproduct, silver chloride. Come out as a byproduct, silver chloride. Then formation of this takes place. If it is not clear, I will write once again. If you want, this is a reaction. Double bond, chlorine will be there. When it is made to react with the AgNO2, this silver and chlorine will come out. NO2 is going to link there. Right? Question number 66 is first option. Then we have question number 67. 67 we have, question number 67. Which of the following statement is correct for SN1 mechanism? 67, what is given? Which of the following statement is correct for SN1? The first step, dissociation into intimate ion pair, right? Their cations and anions are going to be formed. This itself, it is correct. Okay, you know that in SN1 mechanism, this happens there. Then 68, a solid is made up of two elements, P and Q atoms. P atoms are CCP arrangement, means P atoms are forming a structure, CCP arrangement, and atom Q are all octahedral voids. Okay. And Q are occupying all octahedral voids and half of the tetrahedral voids. Then simplest compound is half of the tetrahedral void, then simplest formula of the compound. If they are forming, P are forming that, P are forming CCP arrangement, then how many Q will be there? So Q occupies octahedral void as well as tetrahedral void. To occupy tetrahedral void, we want double of that. QR should be double. So therefore, the formula goes to PQ2. Four atoms here, what happens? Four atoms, they are given two element forming P and Q, and atoms, because octahedral void, four atoms peak contribute to one unit cell CCP arrangement. Four atoms of P contribute to one unit cell form QP CCP arrangement, and four atoms of Q form the all octahedral voids. Okay, they are occupying. Who is occupying there? P are occupying, Q are occupying the octahedral void as well as the tetrahedral voids. Right. Therefore, the simplest formula goes to PQ2. Okay, you can think like this also. Like we may get, you may get, if P are 4, then Q are 8, because the 4 particles are forming CCP, then Q will be obviously double of that. So P4, if the options are given like this, P4, Q8, then would have go for that. But simplest formula is PQ2, or you can say PQ2. Therefore, I am going for option number 1. Okay, you know that there is a formula, number of particles in the tetrahedral void is 2n, in the octahedral void is n, where n is the number of particles forming CCP arrangement, means forming arrangement of this lattice. Tetrahedral void is 2n, octahedral void is n. If n is, because a solid is made up of CCP arrangement, means n is equal to 4. Okay, number of particles present in the tetrahedral voids are n, number of particles present in the tetrahedral octahedral is n, tetrahedral is 2n. Here 4 are forming, means here 8 will be there. So ratio will be 1:2. 68 is first option. Okay, 69, some mistake is there in that, so I have written, which of the following gives the halophone test? Methyl alcohol answers halophone test, because you know that for the halophone test, what is the main condition? Molecule should have this group for halophone, any halophone, iodoform, chloroform, bromoform, whatever. For halophone reaction, the must and should molecule should contain this group or this group or this group. Any organic molecule, if you find this kind of structure, they answers halophone reaction easily. Halophone reaction. 69 is fourth option. Then 70, question number 70. Which of the following complex gives pair of enantiomers? Which of the following complex? A pair of molecules which do not superimposable. A pair of molecules which are not superimposable and its mirror images are known as enantiomers, or enantiomers, this is also called enantiomorphs. Enantiomorphs. Here I am going for third option. This you know that, because cobalt structure, if you look at the cobalt structure, cobalt is surrounded by polydentate ligand. Polydentate ligand will be there. This is a chlorine, we have this side En, and this is En. Take the mirror image of this, take the mirror image of this, you will get chlorine this side, En this side. Standard example which gives a pair of enantiomers, which are a pair of molecules which are not superimposable, a pair of molecules which are not superimposable and it's not superimposable on their mirror images, are known as enantiomorphs or enantiomers. So question number 71, a solution of sodium metal in liquid ammonia is strongly reduced due to the presence of. Question number 71, a solution of sodium metal in liquid ammonia, this reaction you try to recall in first year NCERT book. This reaction is given, ammoniated electron word is there. You used to ask, sir, what is ammoniated electron? They show some color because of ammoniated electron. This reaction you have come across in first year. This reaction is given in NCERT book also. Salvated electrons. Question number, liquid ammonia is strong due to presence of salvated electrons. Question number 71 is first option. 72, the select the correct statement of the following reaction. correct statement they are asking you to search. When they are asking this kind of question, no, it is, they are all time consuming questions. They are all time consuming questions, because you have to read all the options and then only the correct option is possible. So 72, select the correct statement for the reaction they are asking. Then you read all the things. If you write the reaction here, if you write the reaction NH4 plus, the what reaction is given, NO2 minus gives N2 plus 2H2O. Here this is undergoing oxidation because change of oxidation state by, you see that -3, and this is undergoing reduction. Both are forming this, oxidation and reductions are occurring. Okay, the oxidation number of N has changed from -2 to 2. They are asking correct statement, not incorrect. Correct statement they are asking. So oxidation number, nitrogen changes from -2 to +2. No, it is changing from -2 to 0. Here this nitrogen oxidation state is changing from -3 to 0, and this oxidation state is changing from +3 to 0. Option number 1 is not correct. Option number 2, oxidation number of nitrogen and ammonia changes from -3 to 0, that is correct. Okay, this I am telling with the help of balanced chemical equation. Then 73, which of the following method is used to purify blood? Okay, this is repeatedly dialysis. In the hospital they go for this dialysis technique for the purification of blood. If they'll go for dialysis if the person is suffering from some kidney problem, if serum creatinine is more, then it means that the kidney is not functioning properly, then they'll go for dialysis. 74, an exothermic chemical reaction occurs in 2 steps. This is a fast step and this is a slow step. The progress of the reaction can be best represented. Okay, what is happening, you see there, first one, A plus B is converting and forming X there. Okay, activation energy, 2 peaks will be there here. For an exothermic reaction, there are fast and slow. A plus B is giving X, X is giving AB. You see, this represent third one. The reaction occurring in 2 steps has 2 activation peaks, the first step being fast, it needed less activation energy, and second step being a slow step, it need more activation energy. So this is lower and this is higher. Low active, because you know that the rate of a reaction is inversely proportional to activation energy. The one for one reaction which is having less activation energy means the reaction occurs fast. So with that concept, so whatever the graph is there, see, this is having less activation energy, this is having more activation energy. So since it is having less activation energy, it is fast. Since it is having more activation energy, it is slow. That is why I am going for third option. On what concept I am going for this graph? With the concept of activation energy. Activation energy is inversely proportional to the rate of reaction. With that concept I am going, that is 74 is third option. Then 75, which of the following are the Newman projections of meso 2,3 butane diol? Rarely these questions are asked. In old syllabus they used to ask many. Rarely these questions are asking nowadays, but you can have idea about these structures also. That is, Newman projection is this, rotation will be there. Okay, represent here A and D, what we have, they are A and D are represent meso compounds because keep on rotating. So here keep on rotating to 180 degree, rotate to 180 degree, you will get some structure, eclipse structure will get. Okay, and this if you rotate 60 degree, then what happens? Eclipse structure is obtained. So they are called meso compounds. Okay, compounds which are having more than one asymmetric carbon atom, even though they containing more than one asymmetric carbon atom, they are optically inactive. They are called meso compounds. 76. Which of the following statement is incorrect regarding the second order reaction? See, 76 incorrect. They are asking, that is second option. Time to complete for 75% reaction is twice of the reaction. No, actually, for a 75% completion reaction, it is a three times of the half of the reaction. So that it is given wrong. 77. Which of the following is a disproportionation reaction? A reaction in which same species undergoes oxidation as well as reduction is called disproportionation reaction. Same species undergoes both oxidation as well as reduction, it is called disproportionation reaction. I am going for third option. Okay, so copper is undergoing oxidation as well as reduction. Here copper is undergoing oxidation as well as reduction. Copper. This is 77. Then 78. Which of the following pair of the compound can be used as a starting material? Which of the following pair of compound can be used as starting material in the Grignard synthesis of 2-phenylbutanol? Grignard synthesis of 2-phenylbutanol. They're asking the reaction. They're expecting this. Methyl, you can say, I will write those reactions. Methyl bromide you take and react with a magnesium, then it forms methyl magnesium bromide. This is nothing but Grignard reagent. When Grignard reagent is made to react with benzoyl derivative, this is benzoyl, ethyl benzoate, C2H5, this is ethyl benzoate. Methyl magnesium bromide reacting with the ethyl benzoate, then we'll get 2-phenyl-2-butanol as a product. Right? 78 is this, what we have is second option. Methyl bromide and ethyl benzoate. Okay, benzoyl derivative it is. 78 is that. 79, the wavelength associated with the golf ball. 79 is given. Okay, some misprinting is there, therefore I have taken entire this one. 79, the wavelength associated this. For this, what is the formula? H is equal to H lambda by M V, de Broglie's equation. H is equal to lambda by M V. We can take, you can take lambda is equal to H into M into V. We can take like this also. Substitute all H values. 6.626 10 to the power of minus 34. M value as 0.2 kg. And velocity, that is 5 × 60 × 60 meter per hour they have given. I have converted everything. Then you will get final answer 2.4 × 10⁻³. This is de Broglie's equation. H is equal to lambda by mv. Okay, I want lambda here because they are asking wavelength. H into m into v, substitute the data, you will get the answer. That is 79. 80th question. Ether is in contact with air for a long time. The presence of peroxide in the ether can be tested by the adding Fe3+ ion. Then Fe3+ ion can be tested by using, Fe2+ ions plus O2-2 plus 4H+ gives iron, undergoes oxidation, gives Fe3+, and water here. This oxidized iron, Fe3+ ion, oxidized iron reacting with the potassium cyanide, it forms a CNS, this compound 3A+. This is blood red color. You might have studied in first year detection for nitrogen. blood red color. So here O2 is oxidizing Fe2 plus to Fe3 plus, then Fe3 plus further reacting with this compound, formation of this thiocyanate compound, which is having blood red color. Question number 81. If the bond forming entities are dissimilar with a different electronegativity, the bond formed has a partial ionic character as the electron pair is attracted towards more electronegativity. This is natural. Such a bond is called polar covalent bond. Which of the following lowest degree of covalency? Lowest degree of covalency. See, concept is what? Higher the electronegativity difference, lower is the degree of covalency. More is the electronegativity difference leads for the formation of ionic bond. Less is the difference in the electronegativity of the combining atom, there is a formation of covalent bond. You know that if the electronegativity difference is less than 1.9, then leads for covalent bond. Covalent bond more than 1.9 leads for the ionic bond. Generally, it is taken like this. If the electronegative difference is less than 1.9, covalent bond, more than 1.9, ionic bond. Lesser is the electronegative difference, covalent bond formation takes place. Okay, here you see that cesium is down, chlorine is constant. In the periodic table, chlorine is constant. If you see in the periodic table, what is there? Sodium will be there, magnesium will be there, silver will be there, and chlorine, cesium will be there. Cesium is extreme dead end. Cesium in the first group, extreme dead end. Chlorine is here. So much difference will be there. So much difference will be there. So according to the concept of ionic bond, lowest degree of covalency will be there in the cesium chloride. The first question number 82, the rate constant of the reaction is given. Question number 82. What they are asking is then the concentration of N2O5. See, we can write rate constant into N2O5, molar concentration of N2O5. This is an expression, general rate expression. Rate is equal to rate constant into molar concentration of N2O5. Rate value is given 2.4 10 to the power of minus 5. K value is given 3.0 10 to the power of minus 5. Molar concentration of N2O5 they are asking. If you solve that, molar concentration of N2O5 will get 0.8. Substitute rate value given there, rate constant value also is given. Substitute and find out the molar concentration of N2O5. Then question number 83, de Broglie's wavelength of electron accelerated through V volt is nearly given by. See, for de Broglie's equation, what we have first, lambda is equal to h divided by mv. Okay, this can be taken as h divided by square root of 2em. Okay, substitute that, because ev is equal to half mv square. Substitute all the datas there, you will get 150 by v. That is first option. 84, which one of the following carbon hydrogen bond is weakest for the heterocyclic fission? Which one of the following? Their question is heterolytic fission, homolytic heterolytic means difference of electrolytic negativity means heterolytic fission takes place. Heterolytic fission takes place here, you see, because C6H5 taken thrice carbon hydrogen bond, it get break, heterolytic cleavage takes place. Formation of C6H5 taken twice on the carbon positive charge, on the hydrogen negative charge. Weakest for heterolytic fission. This species is weakest because it is resonance stabilized carbocation. It is stabilized by resonance. Stabilized by the resonance, it is most stable also. So this leads for weakest heterolytic fission. Then question number 85. I will write direct formula. You try in home. This is simple. M1 V1 is equal to M2 V2. Okay. This we want. They are asking for sodium carbonate. For sodium carbonate, they are asking after getting M2, you try for after solving for M1. First, you solve for M1 by substituting the data. Then you substitute in the strength. Strength is equal to molar mass into molarity. Okay, 85 will get the third option. 86 is phenol is weaker acid than water. Direct option. Fourth statement is correct because of resonance stabilized. Phenol resonance, it gets stabilized by resonance. 87, calculate the value of E naught. Very important concept, that is E naught concept. Question number 87, you'll get third option. E cell is equal to E naught of iron plus here E naught of tin. It is undergoing oxidation, not reduction there. Sn2 plus 2, reduction there. Calculate E cell of the standard reaction, which is higher you have to take always. Don't see all these things, don't, not necessary. See, this is not necessary according to me. The equation is correct. Simple logic is what, which is if you wanted to find out E cell, E of cathode, E of minus E of anode, right? This formula you know that. Always what you have to do, higher value minus lower value, you have to do minus 0.4 minus of minus 0.44 volt. Okay, minus 0.14 minus 0.44 volt. Okay, because minus 0.14 is more than minus 0.44, then we'll get answer here. For according to the cell reaction, we are getting, now you should get positive 0.30 volt. Standard reduction potential of this is given. The cell reaction Fe2 plus is undergoing reduction, tin is undergoing oxidation. The E naught of the cell is always positive. Remember students, minus 0.30 is not correct. So it is actually supposed to be plus 0.30 volt, plus 0.30 volt. Clear? Because E cell never comes to negative, always it is positive. Remember students. Okay, 87 is a third option. 88, which of the following code is incorrect regarding the allotropic form of carbon? That is second option directly. 89, all alkali metals and alkaline metals of S block elements. That is second option. The 90, monomer of nylon 6,6 is first option. That is caprolactam. Caprolactam is a monomer of nylon 6. This is a monomer of nylon 6. So friends, this completes the discussion. Tomorrow we'll go for another discussion. Okay, and answer key will be displayed after 6 p.m. with the detailed solution, it will be displayed after 6 p.m. Fine.